गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. यस्टरडे द स्नेक एंड द मिरर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट यूनिट दिस लेसन वाज स्टार्टेड. द लेसन विल बी कंटिन्यूड इन टुडेज क्लास. यस्टरडे आई टोल्ड यू द अबाउट होम्योपैथी डॉक्टर एंड हिज एक्सपीरियंस विथ द स्नेक. द स्टोरी इज ह्यूमरस. डॉक्टर हैज टेकन ए रूम for rent and the room was with a tiled roof. One day he went out and took a meal outside in the restaurant and came back to his room. And that was summer, hot summer night. That is 10 o'clock. At that time he opened the room and he sat on the chair and he heard a noise from above, but the noise was familiar one. One could say that he and rats could share the room because why did he say like that? There were many rats in the room, so very often the rats made sounds, so those sounds are familiar to the doctor. But this time noise has come from the above number of times, and he sat in front of the mirror on the chair. He sat on the chair and in front of the mirror, he took the book from the box. The book name was Materia Medica, and at that time he was tempted to see into the mirror. He had taken an important decision, that is he would grow a mustache, thin mustache on his lip and upper lip. And he would keep smile on his face because he was a young doctor, but too unmarried. He was a bachelor. So another important decision, earth-shaking decision he has taken, that is he would marry. What kind of a woman he want to get married? She was a doctor and with good medical practice, and she had a plenty of money, and she would be fat. For a valid reason. What is the valid reason? If he made any silly mistake, she wouldn't run to catch him. So for this reason, the woman would be very fat. Up to that part, yesterday the lesson was completed. Today the lesson will be completed. Shall I read a paragraph? Another paragraph. With such thoughts in my mind, I resumed my seat in the chair. In front of the table, with all these thoughts, he took back. Resumed means took back. He took back his seat again in the chair in front of the table. There were no more sounds from above. At that time, no more sounds. Before that, he heard 3 or 4 times noise from above, but this time there were no more sounds from above. Suddenly there came a dull thud as if a rubber tube had fallen to the ground. Suddenly a dull sound. How is the sound? A rubber tube had fallen on the ground. Like that the sound was. And surely nothing to worry about. Even so, I thought I would turn around and take a look. So nothing to, he doesn't worry. Sounds are very common, sounds are familiar to him, so he doesn't worry. There is no worrying. Even so, I thought he wanted to see, but no sooner had I turned than a fat snake wriggled over the back of the chair and landed on my shoulder. Wriggled means twisted and turned the body to move. Suddenly there came a dull thud as if a rubber tube had fallen to the ground. Surely nothing to worry about. He had no worry about it, but he wanted to turn back and look at it. But no sooner had he turned that a fat snake turned immediately and landed on his shoulder. The snake's landing on me and my turning were simultaneous. Both are at a time happened. What were them? Snakes landing on his shoulder and he was looking back at a time. Simultaneously, those two actions are happen. I didn't jump, I didn't tremble. He didn't jump. He sat at the same place. And he didn't tremble. Tremble means shiver. He didn't shiver. He didn't cry. There was no time to do such thing. So, what does he say? There was no time to do such thing. What things? He didn't jump. He didn't tremble. The snake slithered along my shoulder and coiled around my left arm above the elbow. Snake slowly moved very smoothly. The snake moved very smoothly and slowly along my shoulder and coiled around my left arm above the elbow. Slowly the snake coiled. The snake coiled. Coiled means round and round. His left arm above the elbow. The hood was spread out. Expanded part of snake's head. The hood means expanded part of snake's head. The hood was spread out and its head was hardly 3 or 4 inches. Just 3 or 4 inches from his face. It would not be correct to say merely that I sat there holding my breath. I was turned to stone. He stopped his breathing also. Suddenly he was turned to stone, like a stone. But my mind was very active. He turned to snake. His body turned to snake, but his mind was very active. His mind was very active. The door opened into darkness. The room was surrounded by darkness. In the light of the lamp, I sat there like a stone image in the flesh. In the light of the lamp, he had kerosene lamp on the table. In the light of the lamp, he sat there like image of flesh. Like a stone, he sat there. He doesn't move. He stopped his breathing also. I felt then the great presence of the creator of this world and this universe. God was there, he said. God was there. He said to himself, there was nobody. He said to himself, he felt that the great presence of the creator of this world and this universe, God was there. Suppose I said something and he didn't like it. I tried in my imagination to write in bright letters outside my little heart the words, oh God. So he tried in imagination. He doesn't move. Suddenly he turned to stone like a stone he sat, and in his imagination on outside of his heart he had written words, oh God. There was some pain in my left arm. It was as if a rod made of molten fire. There was some pain in his left arm, not a normal pain, a big pain. That pain will be thick leaden rod. No, not leaden rod. Leaden means made of lead. The rod made of lead. No, rod made of not lead, molten fire. Molten fire means the rod was fired heavily. It was slowly put powerfully crushing my arm. The rod made of molten fire was slowly but powerfully crushing his arm. He felt like that powerfully, very slowly, powerfully crushing his arm. The arm was beginning to be drained all strength. What could I do? He doesn't know. What could he do? What he has to do? He doesn't know. The arm was beginning to all the strength. He lost all the strength. It was beginning, started to lose all the strength. At my slightest movement, the snake would strike me. Slightest, very little movement also would bite him. The death lurked 4 inches away. Lurk was around secretly. Just 4 inches. Death is just 4 inches away. Suppose it struck. What was the medicine I had to take? Suppose snake would bite him. What medicine he has to take? He was thinking. He was sitting like a stone, but his mind was working very active, and he was thinking what medicine he has to take if the snake would bite him. There were no medicines in the room. I was but a poor, foolish and stupid doctor. There were no medicines. He was very A poor doctor, stupid doctor, foolish doctor, he said about himself. I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. So he forgot the danger, what is going to happen, and feebly, there is nothing to do. That's why feebly, just feebly means weakly. Feebly means weakly. Weakly he laughed at himself, at the plight of his situation. He laughed at himself. Weakly, not joyful laughing, weakly laughed at his, at him. It seemed as if God appreciated that. It seemed as if God appreciated that. The snake turned its head. It looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. It seemed as if God appreciated that. Snake turned its head. It looked into the mirror. Actually, God also has shown some sympathy, and snake turned its head, it looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. Snake also saw its reflection in the mirror. I do not claim that it was the first snake that had ever looked into a mirror. So it was the first snake, he didn't think, but he didn't say, but the snake looked into a mirror. He doesn't say it was the first snake looking into the mirror, but however the snake was tempted to see, to look into the mirror. But it was certain that the snake was looking into the mirror. Was it admiring its own beauty? Was it admiring its own beauty? It was tempted to look into the mirror. It was certain, it was sure the snake was looking into the mirror. But was it admiring its own beauty? He questioned himself. Was it trying to make an important decision about growing a mustache or using eyeshadow and mascara or wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead? Mascara, a substance. Mascara means a substance put on eyelashes. A substance put on eyelashes to make them look dark and thick. To make them look dark and thick. Mascara means a substance put on eyelashes to make them look dark and thick. Vermilion, bright red in color. So, was it taking an important decision or using eyeshadow and mascara, wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead? I did not know anything for certain. What was it thinking? What was the snake thinking? What he doesn't know. Sure. Was it what sex was the snake? Was it male or female? No, I don't know. I will never know, for the snake unwound itself from my arm and slowly slithered into my lap. So he doesn't know, for the snake unwound itself from my arm and slowly slithered, slowly moved into his lap. From there it crept onto the table and moved towards the mirror. From onto the lap and slowly crept and reached, settled in front of the mirror. Perhaps it wanted to enjoy its reflection at closer quarters. Perhaps it wanted. Okay, probably it wanted to enjoy its reflection. Reflection means image, its image. It wanted to see its image in the mirror at closer quarters. Closer quarters means very close, very near. It wanted to see. It was also tempted to look into the mirror. So slowly from his left arm it moved very slowly and reached to in front of the mirror, and it wanted to see its image at closer quarters. I was no mere image cut in granite. I was suddenly a man of flesh and blood. So whenever the snake left his left arm and slowly moved onto the table and fixed in front of the mirror, so he was not a stone. Immediately he turned a man of flesh and blood. Up to then, without stop breathing and silently, he sat like a stone. He stopped his breathing also. Then whenever the snake moved, left his arm, suddenly he became a man of flesh and blood. Still holding my breath, I got up from the chair. Still he held his breath and got up from the chair. Very quietly went out through the door into the veranda. From there I leapt into the yard and ran for all I was worth. As fast as he could, he ran and ran, ran and ran till he reaches his friend's house. Phew, each of us heaved a sigh of relief. All his friends heaved a sigh of relief. All of us lit BDs. Somebody asked, "Doctor, is your wife very fat?" "Doctor, if you wished, you would marry a fat woman. Is your wife fat?" So one of them asked doctor. "No," the doctor said, "God willed otherwise. My life companion is thin, reedy person with the gift of a sprinter." He's a thin, very thin person, thin, reedy person with the gift of a sprinter and a runner too. Sprinter means runner. So God willed otherwise. His life companion is very thin and a runner, good runner also. Someone else asked, "Doctor, when you run, did the snake follow you?" One of his friends asked him again another question. "What is that question? When you ran, did the snake follow you?" The doctor replied, "I ran and ran till I reached a friend's house. I immediately smeared oil all over myself and took a bath. I changed into fresh clothes. So I didn't see back until I reached my friend's home. I ran and ran, and after reaching his house, I smeared oil, applied all my body and took a bath and changed into fresh clothes," he said. "The next morning at about 8:30, I took my friend and one or two others to my room to move my things from there. So about 8:30 next day morning, I took my friend and one or two other members, took them and we came back to our room to take his things. That means to take his things. But they found we had little to carry. There was nothing to carry. Some thief had removed most of my things. The room had been cleaned out. So there was nothing to take. The room was cleaned out. But not really. The thief had left behind one thing as a final insult. So not really almost all the things were removed by thief, but only one thing, that was an insult to the doctor. "What was that?" I asked. One of his friends asked. The doctor said, "My vest, the dirty one. The fellow had such a sense of cleanliness. The rascal could have taken it and used it after washing it with soap and water. If he had taken it, he could have washed with soap and water. After washing, he had to wear. But it final insult. He felt like that. It was final insult. He left the dirty vest in the room. Almost all things were stolen by the thief. Did you see the snake the next day, doctor?" The doctor laughed. "I have never seen it since." He never seen in his life again. It was a snake which was taken with its own beauty. It was a snake which was taken with its own beauty. It was the snake. It felt it was tempted to look into the mirror and its own beauty. So in that way, a homeo doctor has shared his experience with a snake to his friends. It's a humorous story. Students, read whole lesson and find out difficult words or new words and write in your fair notes. Important grammar topic, we meet again in the next class. Thank you.